I did stuff where he talks with Thumper, and Thumper tells him, no, no, don't eat that green stuff, just eat the blossoms.
No, no, not that green stuff. Just eat the blossoms. That's the good stuff.
Thumper?
Yes, Mama.
What did your father tell you?
About what?
About eating the blossoms and leaving the greens.
Oh, that one. Eating greens is a special treat. It makes long ears and great big feet. But it sure is awful stuff to eat.
And that became a kind of a running gag, with Thumper always saying the first thing that popped into his head, and made that was part of what made his character so good, besides the great voice.
As an illustrator, Ollie liked to draw beautiful girls. As an animator, he brought those girls to life in Fantasia.
I enjoyed drawing the girls, and I think they came out pretty good. And I did most of the close-up stuff on the girls where the Cupids were making the hats. And the big challenge there wasn't so much of any emotion in that particular thing. It was more the entertainment that you could get out of watching something being made. I enjoyed characters more like the little reason and emotion character, the little girl who was so flamboyant and so impulsive and wanted to do everything that popped into her mind. If she'd see something to eat, that's what she wanted right away. She couldn't control herself.
A club sandwich with potato salad.
But I insist. Tea and
a four-decker club sandwich with cheese and ham and tuna and chicken and mayonnaise.
No, 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 no!
Make some chocolate ice cream with whipped cream on top of it, cherry.
Remember, we're on a diet, please.
And for dessert, I'll have chocolate layer cake with fudge icing.
Oh, dear, we shouldn't go.
Oh, the cherries on top.
Oh, 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 stop it!
And here again, you have the evidence that uncontrolled emotion can cause you a lot of trouble.
The most famous of Ollie's girls also caused him the most trouble.
Nothing made too much sense for Alice in Alice in Wonderland. Every character she met had some strange attitude that she was in conflict with all the time. This is a scene of Alice that I did in the section where she's talking to the doorknob. And she's very exasperated here in this particular scene. But you can also see how confining the drawings are. They have to be so accurate, because everybody knows what a real girl looks like.
Oh, no use. I forgot to tell you. I'm locked.
Oh, no.
But, of course, you've got the key, so...
What key?
Now, don't tell me you've left it up there.
Ollie's flair for animating the fair sex landed him a triple assignment in Sleeping Beauty. Flora, Fauna, and Merriweather.
At first, when we started on them, Walt thought, gee, why do we have to make these characters different, you know? Why can't they all be the same, react the same? We thought, oh, no. Gee, that wouldn't be half as much fun, you know, making them like Donald's nephews or something. So that was one time when we kind of went against what Walt had suggested. But I think it did make the picture richer to have them that way. Little Merriweather was a feisty little thing that'd get upset real easy. Fauna was always the one trying to say pour oil on troubled waters to keep peace between Flora and Merriweather. Because Flora was not what you'd call an appointed leader. She just automatically sort of became the leader because she had the best ideas. But all in all, the three of them formed a happy team.
I'll turn her into a flower.
Maleficent?
Oh, no, dear. The princess.
Oh, she'd make a lovely flower.
Don't you see? A flower can't prick its finger.
It has nails.
No, that's right. She'll be perfectly safe.
Until Maleficent sends a frost.
Yes.
Oh, dear.
She always ruins your nicest flowers.
Ollie's favorite triangle of characters sprang up from the Song of the South. Brer Rabbit, Brer Bear, and Brer Fox were an animator's delight.
Song of the South had great characters and great voices. The fox in particular was a real rich character. He was so sure of himself and so sure of what he wanted. But he had this one weakness, that he would always fall for any ruse that the rabbit had. The fox kept catching him, and then the rabbit would somehow trick him and get out. And the rabbit could usually get the bear involved on his side, and he was always able to use him in escaping. So he had a wonderful triangle there.
What you doing up there?
Oh, keeping the crows out the cornfield. I's making a dollar a minute.
A dollar a minute?
Indeed I is. Would you like to make a dollar a minute, baby?
Thank you, Brother Rabbit.
That's all right. So long, Brother
Rabbit. I'll never forget this.
Yeah, goodbye.
I just don't know how to thank you.
Goodbye. Oh, no.
In Robin Hood, Ollie animated the hilariously unequal relationship between ruler and ruled.
Prince John was a very egotistical guy, but also very insecure. So you had a lot of emotional qualities that you were involved in handling him. And he had this sycophant of a counselor, Sir Hiss, who really had no choice but to stay with this guy because nobody else, who else would have him? So. He became kind of sympathetic, and it was partly due to the great delivery on Terry Thomas, who gave him this kind of mincing quality, and also we used that gap in the teeth that Terry Thomas has to let the little tongue dart through. But that was a pair that you won't often get to animate.
Enough! Hiss! You deliberately dodged.
But, sire, please.
Stop sniveling and hold still.
Thank you, sire.
Another comic foil Ollie brought to life was Captain Hook's bumbling first mate, Mr. Smee.
Walt put me on Mr. Smee on Peter Pan, and I was real happy with that. He's one of my favorite characters, and I guess, in fact, I looked a little like him, or he looked a little like me, because he was bald-headed, made it more fun. And he was a kind of a foil for Captain Hook. And if Hook wanted something to happen, he knew that he could get Smee to make it happen just by saying the right thing. And so he's trying here to get information out of Tinkerbell, and he uses Mr. Smee to help him get that information.
That's it, Smee! We'll Shanghai Wendy.
Shanghai Wendy, Captain?
Take her to sea with us. With her gone, Peter will soon forget this mad infatuation. Come, Smee. We must leave immediately. Surround Peter's home.
But, Captain, we don't know where Peter Pan lives.
Great Scott, you're right, Smee. What's that, my dear? You could show us the way. Why, I never thought of that.
Take this down, Smee.
Mr. Smee wasn't Ollie's only cartoon look-alike. In The Rescuers, he not only gave Rufus the Cat his good looks, he also gave him more than a touch of that Johnston charm.
I had a scene in Rescuers where Penny carries the cat out to go to supper. And she could have just walked out and had the cat follow her, but I wanted to show how much she liked the cat, how affectionate she felt, and how the cat felt about her. So I had her pick the cat up in a way, really, that practically strangles the cat, but he loves her so much he doesn't want to say anything about it. And she starts walking with him, and he starts to slip, and she has to boost him up. And it's much easier to do a walk like that than it is just a regular walk, where she has something definite she's trying to express, some emotional state.